in the refuge in Antarctica. Some decades have passed since the asteroid impact. Over time, small mammals, who are our ancestors, seem to have gradually risen to prominence. However, in this scenario, the giant dinosaurs are still living on. The male has grown to a length of 35 meters now. Behind the pair are their offspring. Paleontological studies have provided a clear picture of certain dinosaurs that actually lived through the impact winter and are still alive to this day. They are birds. We now know that birds are avian dinosaurs that evolved from non-avian dinosaurs. The evolution is thought to have occurred in the Jurassic. It was the discovery of a fossil of a feathered dinosaur in the 1990s that led to the recognition that birds evolved from dinosaurs. Since then, with more discoveries of feathered dinosaurs, there's become no doubt that birds are indeed direct descendants of dinosaurs. So why then did avian dinosaurs, birds, survive while the other dinosaurs have disappeared? Previously, their differences in sizes were given as the cause. Many scientists reasoned that compared to birds, dinosaurs were overwhelmingly large. And since they required a lot of food, they couldn't adapt to the rapid changes in the environment, which led to their extinction. But Tanaka thinks that couldn't have been the reason. His group has unearthed tiny non-avian dinosaurs that were smaller than birds. If size made the difference, why did these tiny dinosaurs become extinct while birds did not? He says the exact reason is still unknown. Then why did the birds remain while the other dinosaurs have gone? It's believed that the asteroid impact also caused other disasters than what we have seen, like global warming and ocean acidification. So did these conditions drive the dinosaurs into extinction? What decided their very different fates? There's no end to the mysteries surrounding dinosaur extinction. There's a researcher who claims that the dinosaurs may have walked the Earth much longer, well into the Paleocene, the early Cenozoic era, even 200,000 years after the asteroid strike. This is the man who made the shocking announcement, James Fassett, formerly with the U.S. Geological Survey. published in a report that he found this huge dinosaur bone from a Paleocene stratum, which is after the asteroid impact, above the line where no dinosaur bones are supposedly found. This is the bone of a duck-billed herbivorous dinosaur, the Hadrosaurid. It's a close cousin of Edmontosaurus, the dinosaur that laid the eggs in the mound. Fassett discovered the bone in the Northern Hemisphere, in New Mexico, USA, relatively near the impact site of the asteroid. From the same stratum of the Paleocene, he discovered fossils of four different species of dinosaurs. He claims that a variety of dinosaurs could have coexisted for some time with the mammals that had begun to dominate.
We have the bone in the cliff, below it here, coal bed that we had collected and analyzed, and it's Paleocene pollen, no question. So it's a Paleocene dinosaur, we know that.
Let us see what James Fassett imagines. 200,000 years after the asteroid impact, in the Paleocene, the early Cenozoic era, the age of mammals has begun. Here comes a mammal. At the time, mammals were about the size of a modern-day capybara. During the dinosaur age, most of the mammals were about the size of a small mouse. But about this time, they're beginning to get larger. But still existing with them is this king. Fassett claims that giant dinosaurs like this Edmontosaurus were still living among the mammals, at least in some parts of the world. This is the Paleocene world James Fassett envisions.
Yeah, after the asteroid impact hit the Earth, we all know that it was a devastated environment. However, in various sites throughout the country and throughout the world, a short time later, a very short time, the plants came back, and they came back abundantly. There was less vegetation, and the dinosaurs were happy eating that, and T-Rexes were eating them.
But the number of experts who refute the findings in Fassett's paper is not small. They say that the fossil had made its way into the Paleocene stratum only by chance through a process called rework, meaning fossils from older sedimentary beds are redeposited or transformed in newer, younger beds by erosion.